not have a scripture, but once my mom read John 15, it gave me one. So John 15, verse 16 through 19. I'm going to read that, okay?
Amen.
Starting verse 16, it says, "You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you, that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you." Verse 17, "These things I command you, that you love one another." 18, "If the world hates you, you know that it hated me before it hated you." 19, "If you are of the world loves its own. Yet because you are not of the world, but I choose you out of the world, therefore the world hates you." Meaning that you are an ordinary person. Not everybody is that person. So for my words of encouragement, God has chosen everyone as a peculiar person, and not everyone has the same assignment. Not everyone is going to see the assignment or the purpose, should I say, that God has on your life. And no matter how hard you try to stick in or be in with the in crowd, it's just not for you. I think this for myself. I might not even be talking out. But yeah. So no matter how hard you try, you would not stick in, because if God has called you out and if he has predestined your life, even when you were in your mother's womb, whatever you try to do to stick in with the world, to be in the world, of the world, outside of the world, standing on the corner watching the world, it's not for you. No matter what you do, I don't care if you, me, if I try to hang out every weekend and do everything my friends do, it may feel good at the time. But after, I feel such a conviction. Amen. I'm talking to myself. And so, be honest,
right.
Every time I hang out, every time I do things that my friends doing, not that I'm a follower, because I'm very much a leader. So if any time somebody going out, they going out because I told them, hey, let's go out to this, let's do this. But when I'm saying let's do it, I enjoy it. On the truth, I hang out, I enjoy all of it. But as soon as the night is over with, and it's time for me to, you know, take a shower, say my prayers, I feel such a conviction and a pulling on my heart. Meaning, I wasn't supposed to be there. But being that I'm still trying to stick in or be in with the crowd, wow. I continue to do the things of the world.
Yes.
And at the end of the night, everybody else might be sleeping peacefully. But I'm the one that's tossing and turning, asking God to forgive me,
yes.
and saying,
yes.
God,
yes.
why me? Why am I the only one that wakes up in the morning and I feel tears on my face and my face is wet, but everyone else can talk about how good of a night they had?
Mm-hmm.
So whatever you try to do, you can't do it because God has called you out. And I always feel like when I know I'm not in a right alignment with God, everything around me, it gets on my nerves. I always feel like it's a workload. I might not even have a lot of work, but I feel like such heaviness, because that's when I find out that I'm not on the right track with God. God will let you know. He'll tell you his own way. He'll let you know when you're not going the right path that he has destined you for, and when you're off track. And even as we get off track, God always has his arms wide open, willing to bring you back in. But you have to first take that step to go back in that place. And the first step is acknowledging you're wrong, being honest. Because if you don't be honest with the things that you're doing, you continue to hide it. And with hiding it and pulling the cover over it, you making it seem good. You making it want to be good. But if you be honest, once that honest come out, you take the heaviness and the cover off of you, and it allow God to come in and to renew you, to clean you, to give you a clean slate, to purify you, to let him know that, yeah, I see what you're doing, but the best part about it, you have acknowledged you're wrong.
Amen.
I feel like as people, we always have that woe is me syndrome, or woe is me, someone's doing this to me, woe is me, my life going around, but we never accept our own fault. We never say, hey God, I did this. Hey God, I drank that by myself. No one made me drink that. No one made me hang out. No one made me skip school. You did it by your own self. You may say, oh, my friends, no, because if you didn't want to do it, you would have never did it. If I didn't want to do it, I would have never did it. But since I chose to do it, everything you have in life is a choice. You either choose to do it or you don't choose to do it. Even with your sins, You choose to commit the sins that you're in. Because God had given us a choice even when we came out. You either choose to serve him or you either choose to serve the devil. So it's never, God, well, my friend made me do it. He's going to ask you, what was your choice? What choice did you take in there? You know, what did you do? How did you come into effect with it? When you talk to God, he's not going to ask you, well, since John made you do that, you and John both going to hell. No. He's going to say, well, since you're afraid of how I did that, I'm going to punish you the way, you know, you need to take your punishment. So, like I said, we have to take that woe is me syndrome off and woe someone else made me do it and accept your fault for your own. And tell God the truth. If you can't be truthful with anyone else, if you feel like you can't tell your parents, and this time I'm talking to the youth, if you feel like you can't tell your parents, your friends, your best friends, your cousin, your first cousin, your last cousin, the baby cousin, the first person you can talk to is God, because he don't judge you. Man may say, if you come talk to me, I won't judge you. And a lot of time it's kids and you, and I'm still young. When we talk to our parents, not all the time does we want to hear, you know, what they did back in their days. Yeah, we understand that, but it's a new generation. So don't make me feel like you ain't never did nothing that I did. You know, don't make me feel like that you were saved all your life. Sometimes we need the raw, honest truth. However raw it get, y'all know how y'all be in school, raw. We need it raw. Sometimes we do need the truth. And when they preach to us about the Bible or tell us the things that goes on in the Bible, it's for our own good. I remember when I think I was in high school, middle school, every time I did something wrong, I don't know how my mama found out, but she did it. And she always told me to go read something and ask God to forgive me. I think it was Psalms 91. If you have 51, there you go. If you offended God, and that when you read that, it's a prayer to apologize to God for offending him. So whenever you feel like you offended God, that's what you read. And a lot of times when our parents talk to us, you know, 9 times out of 10, it does go in one ear and not the other. And everybody ain't going to say that. But it does, because you don't want them to preach to you. Sometimes you need somebody to just listen to you as you talk. Not all the time. Even as for adults, when you vent to someone, you don't want someone to always have feedback. You just need someone to listen to you. You know, hear me out. Hear what I'm trying to say. Let me get my emotions and feelings out before you go preaching to me, or before you go, you know, go down my throat and judge me and I'm not even done talking.
Yeah. Right.
You know, like, let me finish talking. And sometimes as children, as adults, youth, we all need that one person that we can just talk to and just allow them to listen. And if you can't do it to nobody else, if you can't find your mom and your cousin and your sisters, God is the perfect person to talk to. When I'm down and out, when I take a shower, that's the perfect time for me to just, I don't even know I'm crying because the water be hitting my face. So if I'm crying or not, I don't know. But during that time, I just allow all my feelings, mixed emotions, heartaches, everything. If I feel like I'm just going through, that's the time when I just really talk to God and be so honest. If you're not honest, no one can help you. You have to, honesty is the best way. I know people say that a lot, but when you grow up, you're going to realize that honesty is the best policy. It's the best policy in the world. If you're not honest, no one can help you. No one can tell you where to go. You won't even know where to go. If you're hiding stuff, you know, it's the best time to say, you know what, God, this is it. You know, I'm tired of going through this. I'm tired of lying. I'm tired of every time I turn around, I feel like something's against me. Just open up your heart, be honest, and just be truthful about everything that you're doing and that you're saying, and allow God to come in and help you. And if your family and friends can help you, but if you're not honest, you can't go nowhere with them. Amen?
Amen. 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 Amen.